Hello, so this is Ante from Croteam. Hi Ante.
Hello Juan.
So we are asking him a few questions about the new game Zero Sum VR. It's releasing really soon on Steam Early Access, is correct?
Yes, that's correct. The game will be out in the next couple of weeks on Steam on Early Access.
Okay, so when did you decide and why to create a VR game based on the VR, on the Zero Sum franchise?
So we decided that I think it was the beginning of this year. Uh-huh. We were tinkering with VR headsets that we got in office because we are devs, we get a lot of new cool tech. And we were hooked. I mean the moment you put the headset on, you are hooked.
Yeah.
On VR, at least it was like that for us. I think it was like that for you too.
This is the magic of VR.
Yeah, that's the magic of VR. So when we tried the new tech, we knew that we had to make the game. So we were tinkering with different game mechanics and we tried on the dual wheel mechanism when each controller in each hand gives you like a gun. And this worked so well that we knew this is our game. This is, well, obviously Serious Sam. It was a no-brainer for us, yes.
Yeah. But Serious Sam has always been a very fast-paced game. So you had to adapt the mechanics of the game
of course.
For a slower action for VR so that people don't get sick playing the game. Can you explain what are those changes to make the game playable in VR?
Yeah, of course. There will be no slowing down. I can promise you that. There is no slowing down. This is still an action title. This is still a Serious Sam title.
Of course.
But instead of chasing around enemies across levels, this time it's a bit different. Enemies are coming to you. So you mow down hordes of enemies, like before, but you don't chase them, they chase you.
They come after you.
They come after you. So this approach enabled us to solve the motion sickness issue, and this was our biggest concern, because for a lot of people, this is going to be their first VR experience, and we didn't want them to lay the headset aside and say, this isn't any good, I'm feeling sick, I won't try this for years.
Okay.
So we wanted people to try it on and say this is amazing and this is just the sort of reaction that we are having right now at Gamescom and we are super excited about that. We are so glad.
Okay. And what are people saying about people who have tried the game right here?
Yes.
What do they say? Are they enjoying the game?
Yes, very much so. Very much so. And they, for most of them, it's they're still. There's first time VR experience as well as first time with Serious Sam VR. So it's always nice to see how people react to the game and to the tech. And it's been nothing but positive so far. Pretty awesome, I would say, yes.
And do you think that old school gamers, you know, people like me who have played Serious Sam since the first game, do you think that kind of people will like the game too?
I believe they will, and I think they at least owe it to themselves to try it. I know a lot of our fans don't have VR headset yet, and we are hoping that this will be one of the games that will convince some of the people to switch and try, at least try the VR, so it might turn them into believers, and users of the tech. But a lot of fans are asking for Serious Sam 4, and we are fans of Serious Sam 4 as well. We are making that game still, but that doesn't mean that Sam gets to rest this summer. He'll be back to kick some ass again.
Okay. So, what challenges did you have to face to adapt your engine to VR? Because you know VR is needs a lot of power. You need 90 frames per second.
Yes.
Was it very hard to get the engine running well with no slowdowns?
Yeah, well this is just one of the things that we needed to solve before making the game. We needed high frame rates, and we succeeded at that. We use our own engine, it's Serious Sam engine. It's Serious Engine.
I've
used it in Serious Sam and the Talos Principle, our latest game. It's been upgraded to support VR. And we've been in contact with a lot of cool guys from both AMD, NVIDIA, Oculus, and HTC, and they were all super nice to us, helped us with anything we asked, and this enabled us to overcome different problems in a timely fashion and get everything sorted out for this release. So we were lucky like that. Yeah.
Okay. So the game will be playable in both HTC Vive and Oculus Rift.
That's right. That's exactly
but
right.
But it will require motion controllers.
Yes.
So the Oculus Rift users will need to have touch.
Yes, that's right too.
No gamepad support for this game.
So far not.
So far not. Okay. And do you think is there any chance to have, for example, Serious Sam 4 to have some kind of VR port or enable VR in any way? Or is focused on, you know, the traditional screen, traditional controls?
Yeah.
Because Serious Sam VR is your first experiment. So do you have any immediate future plans for the fourth game?
Well, if Serious Sam VR was an experiment, then it was very successful so far for us. We have the VR bug, definitely. We are into VR, we want to make VR games. And we've been experimenting with our latest game, the Talos Principle, in VR setting. If you have Destinations on Steam, you can check out the whole level. We ported it from Serious Engine to Source Engine, so you can move around the level and get the feel of how things would work if that was a VR game. And I think I need to shut up now. That's all I'm ready to say at this point.
Okay, we understand. Don't worry. Serious Sam VR can be in PlayStation VR or will it be PC only?
I would love to have Serious Sam VR on PSVR. We had some talks with Sunny, so in time, when the game releases on early access and before it's a complete product, when we finish the design of the game, we'll have some opportunities
to
look into that again and
let's say maybe. Okay, well, Ante, that's all. Thanks so much for your time.
Thank you for stopping by
and good luck with the game.
Thank you.